वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल. स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द क्लिनिकल एबनॉर्मैलिटी ऑफ द सेरिबेलम, दैट इज एटैक्सिया. एटैक्सिया इज द फीचर ऑफ द सेरिबेलर डिजीजेस. सेरिबेलर डिजीजेस इन्वॉल्व द सेरिबेलर कॉर्टेक्स एंड वन आर मोर डीप सेरिबेलर न्यूक्लाई. सो एटैक्सिया इज जनरली रेफर टू द इनकोऑर्डिनेट मूवमेंट्स ड्यू टू डिफेक्ट इन द कंट्रोल ऑफ द रेंज, डायरेक्शन, रेट एंड टाइमिंग ऑफ द मूवमेंट. So let's start. Ataxia. Ataxia is the incoordinate movement which is occurred by the defect in the range, rate, direction, and the timing of the movements. So ataxia, one person which has ataxia cannot be able to walk in a straight line. Either he walk in a zigzag manner. So this is because the issue with the intermediate zone of the cerebellum. So the ataxia patient cannot walk straight, and this is the problem of the intermediate zone of the cerebellum. Dysmetria is one of the type of the ataxia. There are two types of the ataxia, the sensory ataxia and the cerebellar ataxia. The sensory and the cerebellar ataxia are distinguished by the Remberg test. Remberg test is done. If the test is positive, it reveals that the sensory ataxia, in which the person is asked to close the eyes, and if he is able to stand straight, then it shows that there is no sensory ataxia. If with the closed eyes the patient or the person cannot stand straight, there will be the sensory ataxia. So let's start the difference between the sensory ataxia and the cerebellar ataxia. So this is the table that differentiates the cerebellar ataxia and the sensory ataxia. Cerebellar ataxia is due to the damage of the cerebellum, while the sensory ataxia is the damage to the dorsal column pathway or the posterior column, or maybe the peripheral nerves. The site of the lesion in case of the cerebellar ataxia is the cerebellum, while for the sensory ataxia, the lesion site is the posterior column or the dorsal column pathway. The pathology of these ataxia is that the pathology of the cerebellar ataxia is the impaired coordination of the movements, while in case of the sensory ataxia, there is the impaired proprioception. This is because due to the damage of the dorsal column pathway, there is no sensation of the proprioception. Then the deep tendon reflexes. Cerebellar ataxia, there is no reflex breakdown, so the deep tendon reflexes may be changed, but usually pendular. While in case of the sensory ataxia, there is deep tendon reflex is lost because reflex arc is the broken down. Then the deep sensation of the cerebellar ataxia is normal, as there is no damage of the pathway such as the dorsal column pathway, so there is the deep sensation is normal. While in the sensory ataxia, the deep sensation is decreased or maybe lost, like the fine touch, fine pressure and vibration. The sensation cannot be detected in the sensory ataxia patient. Then another difference of the cerebellar ataxia and the sensory ataxia is the gait. In case of the cerebellar ataxia, ataxia with decreased arm swing, the gait is with decreased arm swing. While in this, if the person has sensory ataxia, there is the high stepping gait, the stumping gait, which is the high stepping gait, because in feet there are the no sensation of the dorsal column pathway. So high stepping gait is the characteristic of the sensory ataxia. So this is the comparison of the cerebellar ataxia and the sensory ataxia. Thank you very much.